The new state wellness program has two basic requirements. Workers must complete a wellness assessment on their insurer's website and have it reviewed by their doctor. They're also required to complete a set of healthy activities, like a nutrition education or weight management program. Failure to comply will result in deductions from state workers' paychecks starting next year. Those deductions will begin at $50 for the first year and will increase every year until 2018, when it maxes out at $375. And that's not sitting well with state employees.
I think people don't like being told what to do where their health is concerned. It felt like there was more. I think some people felt there was more stick and less carrot because of the penalties if you don't comply.
And part of the problem today was that there was so much interest in learning about the new requirements, the room filled to capacity with a police officer turning workers away.
Excuse me, ma'am, you can't go in.
I'm here outside the meeting discussing the new 2015 wellness program, where workers are being denied for the second time today. People are becoming frustrated because they want information. All they can do now is hope that the state upholds their promise to plan further meetings. Workers we spoke with say they are uncomfortable with the lack of alternative forms of medical care under the new policy's coverage.
I just worry this is a way for big pharma to push more prescriptions onto people.
We did ask to speak with a representative of the State Department of Budget and Management, which is overseeing the program, but our request was denied. In College Park, I'm Kara LaMena, CNS-TV.